Nicola is a mother of two. She lives and works in Deal, Kent, in the UK, with her husband, Martin. Her family changed forever when her cousin fell ill and accidentally uncovered a mysterious illness that had been in her family for generations.
I'm one of six children. I have an older brother, a younger brother, two older sisters and a younger sister, so I'm right in the middle. I had applied to go in the RAF when I was about 17, and they had asked the question, what did your father die of? And that's when you start to go, well, what did my father die of? As far as I was concerned, I was an ordinary, everyday, healthy person. I was going to live till I was 100 and I wouldn't think about it any more than that.
I'm Nick Barratt, a genealogist looking into Fabry disease, an X-linked inherited genetic disease affecting approximately 1 in 40,000 to 117,000 people worldwide. I sat down with Nicola to learn more about her family history.
So you've got some fantastic photographs here. Now, who's in this one?
Oh, this one is my mum and me and my sisters.
It's fantastic.
So this is my Auntie Margaret and her husband on their wedding day, and this is my dad. The first thing I knew that there was some sort of illness in the family was my sister Lucinda, who said that there was this sort of family illness, because my cousin Sean went from being a healthy young man to slowly deteriorating. First of all, he was tired all the time, then he started walking with a stick, then he was in a motorised wheelchair, and actually ended up being in a hospice place. So she said that because he had that illness, and because our dad had that illness, I definitely should get checked. In about 2006, Sean passed away. And then a friend of mine said, oh, I'm sorry to hear about your cousin. Was it sudden? And I said, no, he died of the family illness. And she said, well, shouldn't you get checked or do something about it? Now, I thought they were doing tests to see if I had Fabry. If you're female and your father has it, you automatically have it. Now, I didn't know that. So I was still hoping beyond hope that I didn't have it. I went up a bit later to see the consultant again, and he's like, of course you've got it. There was no kind of gentle, do you know you have this? Because in their mind, it's quite clear. If you're a woman and your father has it, you have it. There is no question. I felt gutted that I could be so silly as not to understand. I was getting really, really tired, but I didn't know I was. I just thought I was getting old, and that you get tired as you get older.
Nicola had discovered that her cousin had inherited Fabry from their grandmother. Nicola's father had inherited it, and therefore she and all her sisters had also inherited Fabry.
We went on for several years before we started to take it seriously and before Nicola then started to go and find out whether she had it and whether it would affect our children. I was really, really angry, because if Nicola had it, it meant our children could have it.
We do support people in thinking about their family history. We try to do this as part of a team, so the doctors aren't the only ones who talk to patients about this. Our nurses have had specialist training as genetic counsellors. It can be a difficult conversation, but it's a conversation that we're very keen to start and encourage patients to think about.
It would have been helpful to have the pedigree analysis take place earlier, because it would help me to understand a bit more about how it impacted the family.
I've been treating Nicola and her family for several years now. They were diagnosed some years ago and then came to the Royal Free to have their ongoing care and assessment and treatment for Fabry disease. For every patient that we diagnose with Fabry disease, the experience of telling them that they have Fabry disease can be very different. For some people, they may have had symptoms for many years, including pain, sweating problems, fatigue and bowel problems. And for them to have an explanation for their symptoms can be a relief. It's important to conduct pedigree analysis for patients affected with Fabry disease to look for other family members who may be at risk of the condition so that the diagnosis can be made promptly and those patients be offered support and treatment where appropriate. When we see patients, we offer them advice and support around pedigree analysis. Our nurses are trained in taking pedigrees and family trees from patients and explaining to them which other members of the family might be at risk of having Fabry disease. We can offer support and advice to families in how they could make that communication with other family members.
I'm Christine Lavery and I'm the Group Chief Executive for the Society for Mucopolysaccharide Diseases. I think one of the first priorities is to get earlier diagnosis. It is such a tragedy when families get a diagnosis of perhaps a grandparent and then the Fabry cascade takes place right down through sons, daughters, grandchildren and even great-grandchildren. And this would give these individuals a chance to A, get better clinical support and management, to access treatment and also to make informed decisions about their lives.
It seemed as though the disease that had gripped Nicola was the same disease that took her father and cousin. How far-reaching could this disease be in her family?
The doctor said I should get the children tested for Fabry, and I was shocked to think, oh, I could have passed this on. No, not only have I got it, but they might have it too.
In the next episode, find out about how the hereditary nature of Fabry disease impacts the family.